Music composers and lyricists.
Welcome to Music Metadata Channel. In this episode, we discuss what uniquely identifies a musical work, describe IPI and ISWC identifiers, cover writer roles and create our first CWR. In under 5 minutes. There are many people called, for example, John Smith and even more musical works named Love. But registrations must be unambiguous, so a way is required to know exactly which John Smith we are talking about and which work named Love. This is achieved with unique and unambiguous identifiers. For writers and publishers, we use IPI name and base numbers, and for works we use ISWCs, which are becoming increasingly important for collecting royalties. Identifiers are covered in depth in our basics series, the link is above me. For the moment, it is enough to know that these are provided through collecting societies. IPI numbers are assigned when a writer or a publisher first becomes an affiliate. When it comes to ISWCs, the situation is not completely straightforward. We will get back to this in a minute. We will use Free Django Music Publisher Software, DMP in short, to create ISWC request and common work registration files. It can be deployed to a free cloud account without any technical skills in under 5 minutes. Once you've logged in, press on Add next to Musical Works. We put Love in the title field. Move down to Writers in Works section and press on the green plus sign in the Writer column. A new window will pop up. This is where we enter our writer, John Smith. IPI name number and PR affiliation are required for controlled writers. We will skip other fields for now. Just scroll down and press on Save. John Smith now appears in the writer column. We'll choose role composer and lyricists. We'll enter 100% for manuscript share, also select controlled, skip the rest of the form, as we want to keep it simple today, and press on Save. We have just entered all the required data for an ISWC request and a work registration for the simplest possible musical work. An ISWC request requires a work title and all authors unambiguously identified with their capacities. We have identified John Smith with his IPI name number, so we have that covered. His role is composer and lyricist. And he is the only author. Please note that this data is immutable, it never changes for a work. On the other hand, publishers and their roles can change, new recordings can be made, new alternative titles can arise, etc. While all this data is used in registrations, as we will see in the next video, it is irrelevant for ISWC assignment. Speaking about writer roles, in an original work, only 3 roles are allowed, while with modifications, besides original authors, at least one of the other roles is required as well. We will now select this work, select CWR creation in the action menu and press on Go. On the next page, we will choose ISWC request and just press on Save. We just created the first CWR file with an ISWC request for Love, here it is. We will not go geeky and explain this. This file is then sent to the collecting society, who forward it to the ISWC authority, who will then find the ISWC, or assign a new one, and send it back. Actually, we should get back to our story. In the next episode, we move into the 20th century with gramophone records becoming de facto standard music distribution media, the emergence of music labels and their influence on the development of music publishing. In this episode we mentioned IPI, ISWC, CWR and DMP. Here are videos about them for your convenience. I would kindly ask you to like and share our videos with people interested in music publishing, especially its technical aspects. Thanks. Subscribe and hit the bell, so you don't miss our next video.